because some of you came a little early and sat at different tables, I want you to get up and move to a different table, exchange cards, and meet some new people. And you're going to do that in 3, 2, 1, while DJ Protege gives us a beat. Let's do this. From Sandstorm. Where's that computer bag? We're going to give away a couple of things this morning, a couple of goodies. And that question to you is, what does KOBO mean? Anybody? What does KOBO mean?
Hi, I'm Katie Hill with Liquid Telecom, and I think it means money of some kind.
Have you worked in Nigeria, okay?
No, I'm just very good at languages.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, we have a winner. It does mean money. Well done. KOBO, you know the little coins in Nigeria? KOBO. Congratulations. Liquid Telcom, huh? All right, can I get your card later on? No, I'm kidding. Oh, well done. Okay, round of applause for Lindsay there. Well done. The other day, KOBO 360 was voted by the Africa CEO Forum as the most disruptive company of the year in Africa. They deserve a round of applause for that. Congratulations. Kagura, as I told you earlier on, is studying for a PhD at Oxford. She holds a master's in city planning with a focus on transportation from UC Berkeley, a bachelor of science in civil engineering and with a focus on transport engineering from North Carolina State, and a bachelor's in mathematics from Meredith College. Good Lord, who does that? Ladies and gentlemen, put your hands together for the KOBO 360 Africa CEO, Kagura Wamonyo.
Good morning, everyone. Thank you so much for coming in today, for being part of the launch of KOBO 360. We've invited you all as our stakeholders, and so we wanted an intimate breakfast to get an opportunity to tell you about who we are and to officially say that we're here, we can haul all your cargo, everybody. We have the capacity for it. So I'm just going to take you through to understand who are we, what does the tech mean, and also really what's our origin and where we're going. As you may have heard, we're a tech company, but the focus is on logistics. We are pan-African. Which means that, as you have answered, or many of you have failed to answer correctly, we're in multiple African countries. But really, our mission is to build a global logistic operating system, which means we no longer talk about just being in Africa. We're already seeing ourselves in multiple countries in the global south. The idea came in with that in our ecosystem, we have four partners. We have truck owners. We have drivers, we have cargo owners and cargo recipients. And the question became, what can we do to improve efficiency in this? And so the idea comes from that you can achieve efficiency through data and technology. So we are KOBO. For us, that means we're flexible. This means that if you want us to haul cargo tomorrow or last minute today, we are able to do that. If you're looking to haul cargo from, you know, the rural areas to the urban areas, this is something that we are able to do. Or to countries where sometimes transporters don't find favorable, we as KOBO are able to do. We create visibility. This means that there is communication from us. There is technology for that. But there is also one-on-one personal touch that comes from KOBO. Safety. One of the jokes about transport industry is Muzigo itafika. That's not a question you have to ask yourself when you're with KOBO. We're talking about ensuring that cargo arrives on time and is full. Quality service in terms of engagement. Insurance. So we always ensure that our cargo is insured with GIT. And the last thing is reverse logistics. Now, oftentimes we ask ourselves, how can we, the burden of actually logistics or transportation is about 35% the cost of goods on average in Africa. In a continent where people are struggling in terms of making a living or being able to purchase things, imagine what you could do if you could create efficiency in logistics. And so that's what we focus on. You've heard about why Nigeria, why do we have the name KOBO, which is a Nigerian word? And so the question becomes, so we began about 2 years ago. In Nigeria, our two co-founders, Obi and Ife, are from Nigeria. And so we started from there. And it came from identifying the need to create efficiencies in the ecosystem, in this logistics ecosystem, in the supply chain. And so we do this by connecting truck owners with cargo owners through our platform. So as we, you know, like any tech startup, you're trying to understand the market, you're trying to figure out exactly how the product is going to look like, but at the same time, you're trying to grow. The joke is always that when some of you have asked us, oh, you started in Nigeria, what else? The thing is, if you can crack the Nigerian market, it makes the Kenyan market, you know, sounds a lot easier. If any of you have been into Nigeria, you can confess about that. I'm not going to say anything about Nigeria. But that's something you understand. And so for us, this is already something that we're doing, even in this better phase. Tech adoption, much higher in Kenya. People love tech, want to use it, get it. There is a desire for things to get better. If you're in, you know, transport, you know, like, things, it's like you push. It's always like push, push. But in Kenya, you actually get the deep desire for things to get better. And so we came from there, but we really do see Kenya as a launchpad of the Africa region. So we were chosen by Y Combinator. And Y Combinator is essentially an accelerator based out of Silicon Valley that identifies tech startups that have potential. So, for example, Airbnb was part of Y Combinator. And so they invested in us, but also gave us an opportunity to build our product. And through that, we closed our seed round, which was led then by IFC. And so this allowed us to actually expand, not only within Nigeria in terms of the states within Nigeria that we serve, but also within Africa to the countries that were mentioned. And so this is our footprint. You already answered the question. Now, we have physical presence in the 5 countries. However, we do serve markets beyond that. And this is because of the whole trade route. So you can be in Kenya and you're requested to actually deliver something in Malawi. This is something we're able to do. So just being in Kenya or Uganda or Nigeria, Togo, Ghana does not mean that we have not actually been able to serve other markets, but this is where our offices sit. We're very excited that we're looking to... We see Africa as a focus market. I think when you look at where the future of the world is going to be like, be based out of, it is Africa. If you can crack things here, it's going to make things better for the world. And so this is where we are focusing on in terms of where we'd like to go to next. When you look at the transport and logistics sector over the past few decades, it's actually quite evolved, but not yet to where we would all like it to be. And so initially, very transactional service. It's one, you know, a lot of lack of communication. You don't know Muzigo kama imefika kind of language. You have to pay now. I don't trust that you will get the cargo to where it needs to be. And so the industry evolved. You saw the upcoming of bigger transporters, people you could rely on, but then you were still dealing with multiple people with different agendas. Tech wasn't really integrated as outside the whole tracking, actual tracking of the trucks. And so we're now at the age of technology in a lot of industries, which includes logistics. And this means the feedback which our customers expect, in this case the cargo owners, and then bridging the whole service efficiency, and then aggregating transporters. And I'll speak a little bit about this, and the independent visibility as a cargo owner or a cargo recipient. This is where we're moving to as a sector. And so as I even talk, I'll present a challenge to some of the cargo owners and transporters in terms of where would we like to go. So for the platform itself, the app that has been mentioned, quite easy. You place a request. You can do this on mobile or through our computer dashboard. And this goes into the platform. And a couple of the questions in the algorithm is that, where are you located? Where do you want the cargo to go to? The truck type. Do you want a flatbed? How many tonnages? Do you want it covered with or not covered? All these are questions that you have to ask ourselves. And the kind of cargo. Is it something that KOBO actually transports? Then using that, you are matched with the correct transporter. So we say this, and we like that when you live today, that's why you're seeing the word KOBO everywhere, is that when you think logistics, you think of us. You think of KOBO 360. And this is an aggregated single platform, quicker trip scheduling, you know, proper trip monitoring, and easy access to feedback. We are there to always serve you. And so, the one-stop-shop model that I was just talking about. So as a cargo owner, you want visibility, you want reliability, and you probably don't want to deal with 50 transporters to just hold your single consignment. This is where we come in terms of a one-stop-shop, predictable pricing, reliability of service, and then also efficiency in the processes. So we have about 3,000 trucks currently in the KOBO system in Kenya. And this is why would trucks want to join or be a part of this platform, is that they get to haul goods for the big companies. The big companies that usually require so much of this one single transporter, they now then don't need to submit all this because they haul the cargo through us. And then there's the whole down payment. We ensure that you have a down payment before you haul, up to 50%. And then the remainder is actually paid in 7 days or less after you invoice, confirming safe delivery of the cargo. The other is the driver. We have about access to 4,000 drivers. And why would a driver who works with a truck owner, or a driver who drives their own truck, choose KOBO? Is that you have volumes. You always have someone there to actually, you know, when something goes wrong, someone who's there for you, someone who can assist you, or someone who can come to where you are. And then the cargo recipient is, I just need to know that my cargo will arrive when I want it to arrive. Let's speak a little bit about the billing process. And this is where, as KOBO, we see the future of logistics in this market is beyond just what we are doing or what we have, but it's something as stakeholders in logistics can actually be able to do. So right now, the moment is customers make a request on the app, and then the transporter accepts it. The truck arrives, it's loaded, weigh bills are issued and after the driver loads, then goods are delivered to the customer. That's really very good. But if we are adopting tech, isn't it about time that we start adopting online weigh bills or e-weigh bills? Yeah? Those of you in transport, I can already see you guys nodding your head. It's about time for us to say that I don't need a physical paper to actually be able to prove that cargo was delivered. Can we consider an online version? Can we consider it? And the same thing applies in the entire ecosystem. So the truck owner can receive the soft copy, and the cargo owner can accept a soft copy of both the weigh bill and the invoice. And so part of what we're doing is actually we've already launched this product, and it's something that we'd want to work with partners to see. It makes all the difference for everybody. Errors are reduced. you know as quickly as possible where things lie in your supply chain. And so quite excited about that. But as of right now, the cargo owners, I can see you in the room, you do require a physical weigh bill, which we ensure is submitted to you, and the invoice. So again, our four main customers, the cargo owner, the truck owner, the truck driver, and the cargo recipient. So something else to just highlight here is that for a truck owner, you have the element of guaranteed earnings in the sense that if you haul and the cargo arrives on time, you are going to get paid for the service that you offered. We believe in the element of reliability, not just that when you requested for a truck, you got it as a cargo owner, but if I hauled, did I get paid and what happened? For a cargo owner, we've seen, you know, with the Africa Continental Free Trade Agreement, there's opportunities in terms of the markets we can be able to serve. It means that you're thinking about scale. And what we are saying as KOBO is we are a business that can actually be able to scale with you. That we are able, if you tomorrow you ask us, I need 300 trucks, I need 500 trucks, I need 1,000. It's something we can be able to do because we aggregate transporters. And so an advantage in terms of growing with businesses. So what's our reach and clients so far? So these are just examples. So our reach at the moment has been different towns in Kenya, but also in Eastern and Southern Africa. So the different countries that we get requests to deliver goods to. So be it Malawi, Rwanda, DRC, Uganda, Tanzania, you name them. So our clients have been different. So we have FMCG manufacturers, so like Bidco and Chandaria. We have millers like Rafiki, McNeil, and Bakresa. And then we also have clearing and forwarding agents, just naming Interspeed, Fighting Time, and Union. So it also, this doesn't mean that our only focus is these three industries. It's what we have been able to do so far in the past 5 months. So what are we looking forward to? The first thing is definitely more cargo being hauled efficiently and reliably with visibility. And then the other thing is outside that box products. We're thinking about truck financing. And this is essentially opportunities to partner with banks and assemblers in Kenya to provide trucks to transporters. So you use data that you have in your system. You know, how often do they haul? Does the cargo arrive on time? Because this shows you potential of the transporter to actually be able to pay back the loan they've received from a bank. The other is a co-pay product already launched in Nigeria. This is a product where we finance trips for truck owners. One of the challenges in the trucking industry is operational capital. And so this is something that we're very excited to be able to introduce at some point in Kenya. And KOBO Care. KOBO Care means that how can we bring down some of the costs? And these are costs like tires. It's extremely expensive to actually have to keep buying and replacing tires. It's the petrol. It's the vehicle repairs. It's the engine oil. It's the diesel. And this is what we're talking about and products that we are launching. We've already launched a KOBO Care package in terms of diesel, but looking to expand this beyond just diesel. So who is KOBO? It is not a faceless organization. So in Kenya, it's actually team members from KOBO who are here. Could you just stand for a minute? If any of you are here? Okay. Yes. So this is the team that you may not know you interact with. And the team is led by Dennis Kome, who is the head of operations in Kenya. And if you have ever been invoiced or invoiced us, we have the finance manager, who's Daniel. And then, so that the glue that is KOBO runs, the team is led by Rachel Borger. So you can have a seat. Thank you. And I'll finally finish with where to find us. Who are we? Where are we located? You can reach us online, definitely as a tech company, on our website, kobo360.com. You can call us, you can email us. And then we have two locations because of the market we serve. So we have the Mombasa location and the Nairobi location. The Nairobi location is an industrial area near Nairobi at SMK Business Park. And the Mombasa one is in Mombasa town at Raleigh House. So we hope that you will be interested in the work we do, that you will grow with us, and that we will create the efficiencies you're looking for in the industry.
While exchange cards, those of you who haven't done that, and just know that the future looks good here, folks. The future looks so bright, it blinds my eyes, someone once told me, and the future is KOBO 360. Thank you very much, everybody. DJ Protege, why don't you give us some sounds, take us home. Thank you, everybody. Enjoy. God bless. Good day.
You are the one thing in my way. You are the one thing in my way. You are the one thing in my way. You are the one thing in my way.
KOBO 360 is an e-logistics firm, a tech firm that focuses on logistics. We are a Pan-African company that connects cargo owners with truck owners and improving efficiency in the logistics sector. Kenya is the hub of East Africa. We not only just economically, but also in terms of trade. The port of Mombasa is one of the busiest ports. And therefore, when you are in Kenya, you're able to serve the Eastern and Southern African countries. And so that is exciting to us. We also would like to grow with the Kenyan market because we see this as a very tech advanced market. And so being a tech company, quite exciting for us. So we are reliable. I think if you're in the logistics sector, that is something that we consider very important. We're reliable, we are efficient and cost effective. And the other thing is that we understand the market. We innovate to meet the market needs. And the fact that we can scale as businesses scale, our capacity to actually load thousands of trucks makes us stand out and a partner to most of the cargo owners, clearing and forwarding agents, millers in the country. So KOBO recently closed its Series A, led by Goldman Sachs. The purpose of this is to scale. We've been scaling and growing rapidly, not just geographically, but in terms of the number of trips we do. And so therefore, this funding is to go into supporting this and having even further scale.